You're watching the news on Bahrain International. I'm Hamid Shaban. Good evening. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Safriya Palace the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, who introduced to His Majesty the organizers, chairman, and members of the Bahrain Tennis Club on the occasion of celebrating the 40th anniversary of its establishment. His Majesty welcomed the attendees and congratulated them on the occasion, appreciating the contributions of the Bahrain Tennis Federation in promoting the sport and increasing the number of its players. His Majesty directed the Ministry of Youth and Sports to prepare an integrated study on establishing a central tennis court to enhance the status of the sport and host international championships. His Majesty highlighted the development of the tennis sport in the kingdom, which is a result of the support it receives. His Majesty hailed the efforts of His Highness Sheikh Nasser in developing the sport and all others and in encouraging youth to practice it, which was reflected on the accomplishments and honorable results they achieved in regional and international sporting events. He also highlighted the efforts of the Ministry of Youth and Sports and the services it provides to all the clubs in the kingdom, commending the efforts of athletes and their contributions to the development of youth and sports. His Highness Sheikh Nasser then delivered the following speech.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل بلاد المفدى، حفظكم الله ورعاكم. الحضور الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أنا كلام طال عمرك واصل من قلب الرياضة كلها لكم سيدي. سيدي ألغي لكم هذه المحبة وهذا الولاء وهذا التقدير الذي قمتوا به منذ تأسيسكم العالم الرياضي أو البيت الرياضي في مملكة البحرين، منذ رئاستكم المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة وتوليكم هذه المسؤولية والرقي بها في مملكة البحرين. ولله الحمد سيدي وصلنا إلى القمم، ومملكة البحرين تفتخر بإنجازاتها عام بعد عام. والآن الحمد لله لا نقول أننا وصلنا إلى القمة، بل نطمح الوصول إلى القمة ولكننا في الطريق السليم. طبعا هذا لا يأتي من الخافي يا صاحب الجلال، هذا يأتي من الأساس الصحيح ونحن المكملين لهذا الأساس. فالبيت الرياضي يا صاحب الجلالة هو ولله الحمد بيت نفتخر به برجال بنساء بأبطال وبهوا، كلهم قلبهم على بعض ويتمتعون بروح الفريق الواحد. فلله الحمد اليوم في هذا اليوم المبارك نفتخر بذكرى 40 عام لتأسيس نادي التنس، فهي فترة يعني ليست قصيرة وليست طويلة جدا، بل هناك إنجازات كثيرة سواء كانت في مجال الرياضات مثل التنس وكرة القدم وألعاب القوى ورياضات الفروسية وإلى آخره من الرياضات. نحن الآن يا صاحب الجلالة نتطلع إلى الرقي ونتطلع إلى الأفضل، وبإذن الله ما رأيتموه في هذه الفترة إلا ثمرة حصادكم وتعبكم لهذا البيت. فشكرا لكم يا صاحب الجلالة على هذا اليوم ولقائكم برفقاء دربكم في رياضتكم المفضلة التنس. شكرا.
The chairman of the Bahrain Tennis Club Board of Directors, Khamis Mohammed Al-Mughla, delivered a speech on behalf of the club's organizers and members in which he expressed pride in His Majesty's honoring. He stated that the development of the club is the result of the directives of His Majesty and His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al-Khalifa, the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa, and the follow-up of His Highness Sheikh Nasser. He affirmed that the club's keenness on organizing further international championships, pledging to continue developing the club to achieve His Majesty's ambitions and aspirations. He expressed gratitude to His Majesty for his appreciation. His Majesty then honored the organizers and members of the club, Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak al-Khalifa, Sheikh Ahmed bin Mohammed bin Salman al-Khalifa, Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad bin Abdullah al-Khalifa, Sheikh Abdurrahman bin Rashid al-Khalifa, Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah al-Khalifa, Saleh bin Isa bin Hindi, Dr. Ali Mohammed Fakhro, Sheikh Salman bin Sagar al-Khalifa, Yusuf Haider, Khamis Mohammed al-Mughla, Tawfiq Abdurrahman al-Mu'ayyad. His Majesty wished them further success.
الذي حظى باهتمام خاص من لدن جلالتكم ونذكر في هذه المناسبة الطيبة اجتماع مجلس إدارة النادي بجلالتكم في 6 أكتوبر عام 96 عندما بارك جلالتكم مشروع تطوير النادي وكان ذلك بداية مسيرة التطوير وهي المسيرة التي لا زالت مستمرة وتوجه جلالتكم خلال احتفالاتنا بذكرى مرور 40 عاماً بالمكرمة الملكية السامية بتوثيق أرض النادي كما يشرفنا أن يكون لقائنا بجلالتكم في اليوم العالمي للتنس الذي يصادف هذا اليوم الاثنين 6 مارس صاحب الجلالة إن نادي البحرين للتنس وعلى امتداد تاريخه الطويل منذ أسسه جيل الرواد في بداية السبعينات ليفخر أن يكون حاضناً لنسيج متجانس من أبناء البحرين والمقيمين على أرضها يجمعهم ويؤلف بين قلوبهم حب الوطن والقيادة وارتباطهم بهذا النادي العريق وبرياضة التنس وهم بذلك يقدمون مثالا رائعا لوطن واحد يحتضن الجميع صاحب الجلالة إن نادي البحرين التنس مستمر في مسيرة التطوير بتوجيهات جلالتكم وحكومتكم الرشيدة برئاسة صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير خليفة بن سلمان آل خليفة رئيس الوزراء الموقر وبدعم من صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد الأمين نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول رئيس مجلس الوزراء ومتابعة ورعاية سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة ممثل جلالة الملك للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب رئيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة رئيس اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية حفظهم الله ورعاهم إننا نسعى جاهدين بالتعاون مع الاتحاد البحريني للتنس للانطلاق بالتنس البحريني من المحلية إلى العالمية بتنظيم المزيد من البطولات القارية والدولية التي أنجزنا العديد منها بمهارة عالية شهدها بها ضيوف المملكة والاتحاد الدولي للتنس وساهمت في تطوير قدرات كافة منظومة التنس مما أهل النادي للفوز بالمركز الثاني لجائزة امتياز الأندية الوطنية لعام 2016 صاحب الجلالة نعاهدكم على الاستمرار في مسيرة التطوير والعطاء لمواكبة طموحات وتطلعات جلالتكم حفظكم الله ورعاكم في دعم الرياضة والرياضيين وسنسعى جاهدين ليكون النادي على غرار الأندية العالمية من خلال احتوائه على مرافق متطورة تستقطب البطولات الدولية كما سنسعى إلى تشجيع القطاع الخاص للمساهمة معنا في مسيرة التطوير مقدرين لجلالتكم هذه الحفاوة السامية وهذا التقدير الملكي الكبير الذي نحظى به من جلالتكم في مختلف المناسبات والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
After that, His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa honored the outstanding athletes on this occasion.
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه بتكريم رواد وممارسي لعبة التنس الأرضي ومؤسسي نادي البحرين للتنس. سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة نائب رئيس مجلس الوزراء، سمو الشيخ أحمد بن محمد بن سلمان آل خليفة رئيس الاتحاد البحريني للتنس من عام 1991 إلى الآن، معالي الشيخ عبد الله بن حمد بن عبد الله بن إبراهيم آل خليفة، معالي الشيخ عبد الرحمن بن راشد آل خليفة رئيس الاتحاد البحريني للتنس منذ التأسيس إلى عام 1980، معالي الفريق الركن الشيخ راشد بن عبد الله آل خليفة وزير الداخلية، سعادة السيد صالح بن عيسى بن هندي مستشار جلالة الملك المفدى لشؤون الشباب والرياضة، سعادة الدكتور علي محمد فخرو رئيس نادي البحرين للتنس من عام 1973 إلى عام 1979 ميلادية، سعادة الشيخ سلمان بن صقر آل خليفة رئيس نادي البحرين للتنس من عام 1999 إلى العام 2000.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Safriya Palace a number of Fakhro family members. He praised the contributions of the late Muhammad Yusuf Fakhro in developing the economic and commercial march in the kingdom, as well as his initiatives in the humanitarian field. His Majesty also praised the role of Bahraini families in reinforcing the economic, commercial and investment movement, as well as supporting the national economy. He hailed their patriotic stances, noting that they reinforce the values of communication and solidarity, which embody the authentic Bahraini values. Fakhro family members expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty, wishing him abundant health and prosperity. His Majesty also received Khalid Abdurrahman and his wife, nutritionist and researcher in the field of alternative medicine, Aliya Al-Muayyad. His Majesty noted her efforts in spreading health awareness in Bahrain and the region's countries, wishing her further success in her field. His Majesty hailed the contributions of the people of Bahrain and their constant endeavor to serve the country. For her part, Al-Muayyad expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty for his support and encouragement. His Rohanis, the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, received today at Glabia Palace His Rohanis, the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The Rohanises reviewed the regional and international developments, stating that regional challenges require the coordination and cooperation that maintain the rapid pace of development. The Rohanises expressed satisfaction with the keenness of the Gulf Cooperation Council countries on improving bilateral and Gulf cooperation, affirming that their development and advancement reflect their keenness on continuous growth to achieve the interests of the region and its people. Thank you. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa chaired the weekly cabinet session today at Glabia Palace. The cabinet commended the success of the Bahrainian Gulf March towards reinforcing cooperation and integration on all levels, which was reflected by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince's visit to the State of Qatar and the State of Kuwait. The cabinet hailed the results of the Prime Minister's official visit to Qatar upon receiving an invitation from His Highness the Father Emir Sheikh Ahmed bin Khalifa Al Thani. They also lauded His Royal Highness's discussion with the Emir of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, as well as senior Qatari officials. The cabinet also noted the results of the Crown Prince's visit to Kuwait and the discussion held with the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, as well as his visit to Qatar, in which he held talks with the Emir of Qatar. His Royal Highness the Premier expressed great pride in the generous reception during his visit to Qatar. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince reviewed the positive results of the discussions held with the Kuwaiti and Qatari leadership that reinforced the cooperation between Bahrain and the two countries. The cabinet affirmed the importance of such visits that support the ability to face the political, economic, and security challenges inflicted by the regional and international developments. In memory of passing of the late Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa, may God rest his soul, His Royal Highness the Premier recalled with appreciation his contributions in developing his country and serving his people. His Royal Highness stressed the importance of documenting the contributions of Bahraini men and women in serving their country. On the occasion of the Representatives' Council and Shura Council's approval of the constitutional amendments, His Royal Highness the Premier lauded the cooperation of the legislator, hailing its role in increasing the effectiveness of procedures that preserve the country's security and stability. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister directed the improvement of the current applied procedures regarding small financial claims and the implementation of provisions relating to the use of electronic means. He appointed the coordinating committee headed by the Crown Prince with this matter. The cabinet approved the recommendation of the Supreme Committee of Natural Resources and Economic Security, headed by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, regarding the proposal of the National Oil and Gas Authority funding a project for a new lab to process associated gas. The cabinet reviewed a memorandum to make amendments regarding the private education and training centers. The cabinet followed up with the reoperation of the government quarry's ability to provide the necessary needs for urban projects. The cabinet took note of the procedure of the memorandum of understanding on the mutual exemption of visa fees for ordinary passport holders between Bahrain and Turkey. The cabinet referred the memorandum of the Minister of Information Affairs to the Ministerial Committee for Social Services, Media, Transportation and Telecommunications. The cabinet referred to the Legislative Authority draft law regarding the amendment of Article 137 of Decree Law 54 and the provision of Law No. 37. The cabinet discussed a proposal of the Representative Council for the establishment of a development of a section in Bahrain National Museum. His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Glabia Palace Saudi Royal Court Advisor and former Minister of Petroleum and Mineral Resources Engineer Ali bin Ibrahim Al Naimi, who is currently visiting the kingdom. His Royal Highness highlighted during the meeting the continuous growth of the Bahraini-Saudi relations based on the two countries' shared history and destiny. He expressed admiration of Saudi Arabia's supporting stances to the safety and security of Bahrain. The Premier affirmed Bahrain's keenness to enhance cooperation with Saudi Arabia to achieve the two countries' aspirations of further progress and prosperity. He noted the role of Saudi Arabia under the leadership of the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdul Aziz Al Saud, in reinforcing integration and solidarity among Arab and Islamic countries in light of Saudi Arabia's regional and international status. He added that since the reign of the founder of Saudi Arabia, the late King Abdul Aziz bin Abdul Rahman Al Saud, to the days of the custodian of the two holy mosques, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has managed to protect the nation from the dangers that threaten its security and stability through relying on policies that uphold the values of cooperation and support the unity and sovereignty of Arab and Islamic countries. The Prime Minister commended the efforts of the custodian of the two holy mosques in developing Saudi Arabia in all fields. For his part, Naimi expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister for his interest in enhancing bilateral relations between the two brotherly countries. He commended the wise vision of His Royal Highness. He hailed the Bahraini-Saudi relations, commending the development of the kingdom in all fields under its wise leadership. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa today departed to Bahrain, concluding an official visit to Qatar. His Royal Highness was accompanied by the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, and a number of ministers and officials. The visit included a meeting between His Royal Highness the Crown Prince with the Emir of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, to discuss historic relations and ways to further strengthen bilateral cooperation across a wide range of areas. The Deputy Emir of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thani, Qatar's Minister of Culture and Sports, Salah bin Ghanem Al Ali, Minister in attendance, and a number of senior Qatari officials attended the departure ceremony. Earlier yesterday, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa toured the Lusail International Circuit in Doha. His Royal Highness was accompanied by the Deputy Emir of the State of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thani, the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince highlighted the GCC's achievements across a wide range of development areas, adding that the sports industry continues to grow and improve across the region. He noted the role of the Bahrain International Circuit, the Lusail International Circuit, and the Yas Island Marina Circuit in hosting international sporting events and facilitating citizens' contributions to the organization of successful motorsports events. He praised the circuit's achievements in hosting prestigious motorcycle races, stressing that motorsports has grown to become a key mechanism for promoting the region and accelerating sustainable economic growth. Her Royal Highness, the wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabiqa bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, received at the Council's headquarters the organizing and supporting bodies of the Bahrain Arts Cross Borders Show. Her Royal Highness welcomed the attendees, affirming that the kingdom has many artistic talents and is based on a long history of creativity. She stated that the show represents an ideal platform for Bahraini artists to showcase their artistic talents, stressing the necessity of utilizing modern technology in art fields to attract youth from universities and educational organizations. Her Royal Highness hailed governmental and private organizations' support for the show, highlighting the role of Temkin Labor Fund in sponsoring the show and affirming that this partnership presents the kingdom through being a leading hub for art in the region. The chairman of the board of directors of Temkin, Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa Al Khalifa, gave a presentation on Temkin's sponsoring of art as a key factor in the development of the economy. For his part, Undersecretary of the Ministry of Interior for Nationality, Passports and Residence Affairs and honorary president of the Bahrain Art Society, Sheikh Rashid bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, commended the wise leadership's support for the art movement in the kingdom and its development in the last years. He emphasized that the number of Bahraini artists is continuously increasing, affirming that the society will continue to support artists. Her Royal Highness listened to the attendees' suggestions on developing the second edition of the show. Al-Mubarak Al-Khalifa Foundation announced that it will host its first forum held under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al-Khalifa. MKF held a conference in which it revealed that the forum, which will be held on April 22nd, will discuss the impact of leadership, entrepreneurship and volunteerism in developing the next generations. The forum will offer an opportunity for Bahraini youth to meet inspiring models and discuss the three main topics of the forum that come in line with the Foundation's vision that aims to create an active and effective generation of young Bahrainis able to positively impact the society. Al-Mubarak Al-Khalifa Foundation, launched in 2011, aims to have a positive social impact in youth empowerment by providing Bahraini students with comprehensive programs and work experience that facilitate their entry into the labor market after graduation.